This is TWiT.
Okay. It's being called Glitch, G-L-I-T-C-H. And GL is in caps in the name of this, as in WebGL. A group of researchers at the university in Amsterdam have developed a new startlingly effective remote attack against Android smartphones using the user's web browser and the device's built-in GPU via JavaScript and the WebGL API. So what this means is they have demonstrated that a user of Android visits a particular website. JavaScript is delivered and runs either under Chrome or Firefox. They tested it under both. And get this, in 2 minutes, the attack is so potent that and I should mention, this is RowHammer. Within 2 minutes, their phone is compromised. So it's the first RowHammer attack to leverage GPUs to leak the computer's memory contents and allow bad guys remotely to compromise a phone. We've been talking about RowHammer for quite a while. Remember that it leverages a essentially noise in RAM access to cause a bit to flip in the actual memory grid of dynamic RAM as a consequence of it sort of being a malicious access pattern. And it turns out that GPUs are far more effective than CPUs. The reason we haven't seen this on desktops before is that GPUs have their own memory. On lower-end devices like smartphones and tablets, the GPU shares main memory with the CPU. So by leveraging WebGL, which gives the JavaScript extremely accurate timing information, they're able to perform a cache attack with GPU, because the GPU has a much shallower cache than the CPU does, in order to compromise the device within about 2 minutes. So what's not clear is whether there has been some fuzzing in the WebGL support on those browsers. There had been some fuzzing in timing in response to Meltdown and Spectre earlier this year. Under the cert.org page, I went looking to see specifically whether Mozilla and Google with Chrome had responded, and nothing was there. Although in digging around, I saw some reference to perhaps this already having been taken advantage of, but nothing yet posted publicly. So it's not clear. Certainly both companies know, and I'm sure they will be arranging to limit the timing accuracy of WebGL. And essentially that's the crucial thing, as we have been seeing a lot lately, to determine whether for RowHammer to be used to penetrate caching, is you have to be able to sense whether a particular access was cached or not. And for that, you need to know with very good accuracy what the timing was. So anyway, we do have, again, another instance of our famously often quoted, and I think it was Bruce Schneier who said, attacks never get worse, they only get better. And so here's RowHammer, which continues to cause us trouble. And hopefully downstream, we will see some improvements at the hardware level. What we know is that it's possible to more intelligently refresh DRAM, either increase the refresh rate, which lowers the bandwidth that we can use the RAM, so it essentially slows the DRAM down but hardens it against attack, or probably in the future we're going to see RowHammer resistant hardware design, which notices that there is an access pattern, which may not be malicious because there's nothing inherently malicious about accessing DRAM. It turns out you can leverage it. So next generation DRAM hardware will probably preferentially refresh rows adjacent to those being accessed heavily in order to prevent these bits from flipping, and thus essentially over time adapt the hardware to the attacks.